So production of the food from the plants yesterday already started. So revision for that. The plants which are grown in a large number to get useful products are known as the crops. The process of the yielding of the crops is called agriculture. So long term crops means which of the crops we can grow for that more than the 180 days or more than 180 days for the harvesting is called long term crops. So examples of the long term crops, jowar, red gram, like. So which of the crops we can take that harvesting 100 days below the 100 days is called short term crops. Example is green gram, red gram, like. Which of the crops we can grow in the rainy season is called kharif crops. Which of the crops we can grow in the winter season is called rabi crops. Rice is the prime most important staple food crop and also called global grain. What I am saying, important points. Okay. Next. So rice was cultivated in the late Mesolithic period 9000 to 8000 BC. The paddy growing field is divided into so many plots that is called kayalu or madulu. Okay. Before the raising of the crops, ploughing the soil properly is the necessary. Wooden plough is used for the ploughing. Agriculture practices including so preparation of the soil, sowing of the seeds, applying manure, irrigation, weeding, crop harvesting and storage. So these are the steps are present in the agriculture. Next, selection of the seeds. Selection of seeds is an important step in the agriculture. National Seed Development Corporation of India preserve and promote the different varieties of the seeds. Nowadays, farmers are using the seed drill for the sowing of the seeds. Wheat, paddy and sugarcane are generally susceptible to the fungal diseases. Farmers use it to the pesticides like diethane, M45, endrine. These are the examples of the pesticide. Weeding increase crop yield. 2,4-D is the weedicide. Full form of the 2,4-D. 2,4-dichlorophenyltrichloroethane. Okay. 2,4-D. What is the full name of the 2,4-D? 2,4-D. Dichlorotriphenylethane. Okay, dichlorotriphenylethane. 2,4-D is the examples of the weedicide. Manures are the two types of the manures are present. One is the natural manure, second one is the artificial manure. Artificial manure also known as the chemical fertilizers. So sprinklers and drip irrigation techniques are used to the drought prone area. Especially we can use it to the drought area, generally sprinklers and drip irrigation system. Proper storage of the grains reduce the damage of the grain by the bacteria, fungi and pest and rats. In the plants like wheat, flowering takes place only during the short night period. As long as the nights are the longer than the 12.5 hours, the wheat plant does not flower. In addition to that, temperature is also not sufficient for the seed formation. So these are called short night plants. In the plants like maize, cotton, flowering will be more when the night duration is the greater than the 12.5 hours. These are called long night plants. In some plants like soybean, night duration is not at all the reason for the flowering. They can give the flowers any time during the year. These are called night neutral plants. Rice is the prime most essential and staple food crop. It is also called global grain. Rice was cultivated in the Mesolithic period 9000 to the 8000 BC and the Harappa civilization 2300 BC. So rice is grown in the Kharif season and Rabi crops. Paddy requires high quantity of the water. The name of the varija for the paddy was given by the lineage. Thousands of the varieties of the paddy are available throughout the world. Varija sativa is the Indian cultivated paddy plant, especially Asia. Varija glabrima, cultivated in the Africa. Varija glumatula, cultivated in the America. Some traditional varieties of the paddy are molagu, lukulu, amritasari, bangar tiga, kolleti kusuma, potti basmati, sona masuri. These are the traditional varieties. In 1960, Raquel Carson wrote the book is called Salient Springs, in which the printed out the danger of the pesticide. Pesticides get into the bodies of the microscopic plant and animals in the soil and water. Okay. So Parthenium, unwanted plants grow along with that crop plants, that is called weeds. Parthenium is the weed has been imported along with the wheat from the Australia long before people got allergy because of the pollen grains of this plant. Sparrow is called farmer's family friend. Agriculture is the flesh and blood of our country. So young generation should develop more passion towards the agriculture, which would be the only beneficial profession in the near future. Leveling. After the ploughing, the field have a lot of up and downs. So leveler is used to the leveling of the soil. Sowing. Planting the seeds in the soil. Broadcast. This is the method of the dispersing of the seeds by the sprinkling. So next, nursery plant. Nursery plant means farmers develop seed beds to grow paddy plantlets. Naru, in a plot which need to have their rods constantly submerged in that water. They are also to be uprooted and transplanted through the field. Manure, the nutrient that enrich the fertility of the soil for the proper growth of the plant. Irrigation, the process of the watering crops, crop plants in the field is known as the irrigation. Furrow irrigation. Okay, in this method irrigation, the water is allowed to enter the field through the channel or furrows which are made between the two rows, like. Okay, basin irrigation, the field just filled with the water as in the case of paddy, like paddy, basin irrigation. Drip irrigation, when the availability of the water is poor, the water is made to reach the plant drop by drop, that is called drip irrigation. Harvesting, collecting of the grains from the crops by the cutting the matured plant is called harvesting. Threshing, the dry plant stalks are beaten and on the hard surface to remove the grains. Winnowing, in the winnowing the grains are the poured out of a basket or tray held high up in the wind blows the chaff, dust and lighter seeds aside while the heavy grains are collected below. So this is about that production from that food crops. Okay. So here they are given to that crop production. The production of the crops is called crop production. Seed crisis. Sometimes the rate of the germination of the seed is not up to the mark. Sometimes never germinate. Sometimes they can grow into a plant, but they be sterile. Sprouting. When the seeds are soaked in the water, they germinate and produce to the shoot. Seed dispersal. The method of the spreading of the seeds from one place to the parent to that parent plant to that another one place to the another place is called seed dispersal. Examples of the seed dispersal: air, water, animals are helping. pesticide to control the kills and the pests like grasshopper and aphids which damage the crops and grain. Farmer use the pesticide. Paddy planted. It is easy to maintain proper distance sowing the seedling. It is time saving. It is useful for the farmers who cultivated paddy. Biofertilizer. This is formed by the decomposing of the plants and animal waste. This is also called natural manure. Chemical fertilizer. The manure which are the prepared in the factories by using the chemicals are called artificial manure. Example, urea, Gromor 28-28-28. Sprinkling, a modern device of the watering plants. Weeding, removal of the undesired plants which grow along with the crop plants. Weedicide, when the crops are fully grown and may not be suitable for the uprooting weeds, farmer use to the weedicide like 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid. 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid control the kill the weeds. Cold storage unit. Here the vegetables, fruits and tamarind, chilies and other products that are usually damaged and decolored with the in a short time can be saved with the no changes for a long time. Godowns, the place where the storage of the dry grains to protect them from the pest and microorganism. So this is about that production food from the production of the food from the plants. Okay, next. So production of the food from the animals. Are you understanding, Avinash? Hello. So next. Production of the food from the animals. Production food from the animals. Actually, animal husbandry means providing of the food, shelter, okay. Providing of the food, shelter, protection and breeding of the animals is called animal husbandry. Animals also providing to food us. So animals like cows, buffalo, sheep represent, they are called livestock. So pasteurization, preservation of the milk is called pasteurization. This pasteurization method was discovered by the Louis Pasteur. So in this pasteurization method, the process in which the milk is heated at temperature 72 degrees for a definite period for the 30 minutes and cooled for the 10 degrees centigrade, then we can cooled after we can send into the cover. So that is in our everyday day-to-day life we are using pasteurized milk. Culture of the birds like hens is called poultry. Culture of the honeybees is called apiculture. People living in the rural area use it to the domesticated animals like cows, buffaloes, bullocks, goat, sheep, pigs and hens. Haryana, Jafrabadi, Nagpuri are the traditional varieties of the cow which give good quality of the quantity of the milk. Inland fisheries. In this system, a combination of the 5 or 6 fish varieties is used in a single fish pond. These species are the selected so that they do not compete for the food among them and have the different types of the food habits. Food processing, preservation of the food item through the processing, sun drying, semi drying, salting, drying and pickling. So these are the methods we are used to the food preservation. Food processing, aquaculture, culture of the aquatic organisms like fish and prawns and crabs is called aquaculture. Bee venom is used as a preservator called epitincture and used to the homeopathic medicine. Cultivating of the fish in the fresh and salt water is called aquaculture. Marine and inland fisheries meet the global food needs. Since long ago, man used animals not only for the obtaining food but also for the agriculture also. Okay, next, peoples living in the rural areas got used to the domesticated animals like cows, buffaloes, bullock, goat, sheep, pigs and hens. So bulls are mainly reared for that using for that ploughing. Taking care of the animal health is also very important task in the animal husbandry. Viral and bacterial diseases also affect on the milk production. Veterinary doctors provide the treatment and health care for the cattle. Our government treat milk production as an industry. According to the Economical and Statistical Survey of India 2011, about 40 to 60 lakhs of the liters of the milk is produced every day in our state. So care should be taken while buying cattle from the milk production. So white revolution, increasing of the quality and quantity of that milk production is called white revolution. White revolution, who is the father of the white revolution in India? Varghese Kurien is the father of that white revolution. Who is the father of the green revolution? M.S. Swaminathan is the father of the green revolution in India. So care should be taken while buying the cattle for the milk production. Biogas production also useful product in the animal husbandry. Production and rearing of the hens on a large scale is generally called poultry. Culture of the honeybees is called apiculture. The bee wax and bee venom are the other product in the apiculture. Fish constitute an important and plentiful source of the high quality animal protein. Our government provide the opportunities to improve the animal food production to fulfill the feeds of the requirements of the growing of the population. So Professor J.K. Kurien called father of the white revolution in India. Please note down. Okay, Professor J.K. Kurien is the father of the white revolution in India. There is a great improvement in the production of the milk under the scheme of Operation Flood. Operation Flood also, Operation Flood and white revolution, both the terms are same. Increasing of the quality and quantity of the milk is known as the Operation Flood or white revolution. Father of the white revolution is the J.K. Kurien. Milk is the secretion of the mammary gland in the animal. During this period, following at least 72 hours after calving or until the milk is the colostrum free, milk appears as a white opaque fluid in which fat is present as a emulsion. Protein and some other minerals like vitamin A and D and E and 80 to 90% of the water is available in the, especially for the milk. So hormone injection used by the cattle rearers to get high quantity of the milk causes early reaching of the puberty. Likewise, chemicals also cause the damage to our health. So especially in the Odisha, traditional livestock, chilka, buffalo, graze during the night time in the brackish water of the Chilka Lake. They return home in the morning and give milk without any extra feed. This milk tastes a bit of salty and is kept up to the 7 days without refrigeration. Are you understand, Avinash?
Yes, sir.
Next, if you want to be a healthy person, eat an egg every day. So for example, if you want to be healthy every day, you can wake up early in the morning, physical exercise you can do, and eat all types of the nutrient, carbohydrate, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. Okay, every day drink the milk. Every day compulsory in your diet, one boiled egg you can eat. So that is the good habits. If you are going to the washroom, wash your hands before, if you are going to the washroom, wash your hands with the Dettol. Before eating and after eating, you can wash your hands with the Dettol. And every day drink at least 6 liters of the water every day. Okay. Are you understand, Avinash?
Yes, sir.
Next, if you want to be a healthy person, eat an egg every day. This is the slogan of the National Egg Coordination Committee. Egg is a good nutritious food which is easily available for the all. So in that egg, what are the nutrients present? protein is present. What is present? Protein is present. Next, do you know emu is the flightless bird? What is the largest egg is present? The largest egg is the ostrich egg is the largest egg. Second largest egg is the emu egg. That is also GK question, very very important. Okay, emu is the flightless bird from the Australia. It is the second largest bird in the world after the ostrich. Ostrich egg is the largest egg. Okay, next, it weighs nearly 50 kgs and runs at 40 miles per hour. Meat, chicks, skin, leather, oil, feathers, eggs are the main products of the emu culture. If you are getting to that emu, what you are getting? Meat, chicks, skin, leather, oil, feather, eggs, these are the products we are getting from the emu bird. So in our Telangana also, emu is the one type of that industry. Okay, they are growing and getting to the money. Next, seaweed. Weed means unwanted plants. They can grow along with that crop plants. We are called weed. Seaweed. So in that sea, unwanted plants they can grow. That is called seaweed. Seaweed constitute an important marine resources and are found along the rocky intertidal and subtidal regions of the coast of India. They are used for the human consumption as cattle and poultry feeds as a manure and for the industrial purpose as the source of the phycocolloidal like agar agar we are getting. Especially this agar agar we can use it to the tissue culture. In the tissue culture, agar agar is the very very important. This is the semi solid material we can use it to that, especially in the tissue culture. This agar agar we are getting from that seaweeds. Okay, next. So do you know Jersey and Holstein? So this is the hybrid varieties. Actually, traditional varieties of the cows and buffaloes, they are giving to the very little amount of the milk. So that's why we are getting to the very little amount of the milk. We can prevent that little amount of the milk we are getting to that hybrid varieties. This hybrid varieties is the Jersey and Holstein. Jersey is the England and Holstein is the Denmark, are the foreign varieties of the cows. They give the 25 liters of the milk for a day. Every day our traditional varieties of that cows, they are giving to that only 0 to 5 liters. But these are that foreign varieties, they are getting to that at least for a day 25 liters of that milk we are getting. These are the foreign varieties. Okay, hybrid variety, Jersey and Holstein. Jersey is the England and Holstein is the Denmark cows. Biogas. So what are the waste material coming from that plants and plant product? Animal excretia, with the help of the animal excretia we are using to that production of the natural gas. That is nothing but biogas. The dung obtained from the cattle is mixed with the bacteria and is used for the production of the biogas. Generally these are the biogas we are getting from that cow dung. Excretia of the animal, this is the mixed with the bacteria, that production it will come, biogas production it will come. Hatching. Do you know very well that hens are lay the eggs after the 21 days they are hatching, after that small chicks will come. So hatching, the placing the egg under the broody hen to produce the chicken is called hatching. Incubator. Incubator means especially in the poultry farm generally. So if that hatching purpose natural hens, they can sitting in that especially in that eggs, but in that we can provide to that lights because of that. That is the incubator. Incubator is an apparatus for the hatching of the eggs. Next, honey bee hive. So in this honeybee, you know very well, a construction of the six-sided wax compartment made by bees to store honey and eggs. In that honey also, three types of that bees are present. One is the queen bee, and second one is the drone, and third one is the workers. Third one is the worker. So queen, only one queen is present. Who are present? One queen is present. What is the functions of the queen? Queen, only one queen bee is present in the colony. The function is to the lay eggs for a day, 800 to the 1200 eggs laying. So that is the queen bee only lay the eggs. Okay. Next one is the workers. So workers, what they are doing? Only these are the workers. These are the sterile females attend indoor duties. Collecting the nectar, okay, collecting the nectar, different source of the flowers, that is the functions of the workers. And drone, so drones are the male members of the honeybee colony. Their main duty is to participate in the mating, especially reproduction. Male gamete releases to the male organism releases to the male gamete, female organism releases to the female gamete. Fusion of the male gamete and female gamete is called fertilization. Fertilization takes place, zygote is formed, zygote developed into the embryo, embryo give rise to the new baby. So that means queen bee is the laying the eggs, drone is the male member, they are participate in the reproduction. Actually in the honey bee hive, three types of the bees are present. One is the queen bee, only one queen bee is present. They are the laying the eggs, drone. So these are the drones, are so many numbers are present. These are the participate in the reproduction. And workers are the only sterile females. They can collecting that nectar from the different source of the flower. Honey wax. So besides that honey, wax is produced by the honeybees is known as the bees wax, or honey wax is used the production of the cosmetic, shoe polish, candy, leather industry. For example, especially nowadays you are using to the lipstick, actually this honey wax is present, okay, and shoe polish, and especially leather industry, generally we are using to, these are the honey wax. Next one, okay, marine fisheries. So actually in our India, okay, marine ecosystem is the 3/4 of that land is covered with that water. In that most of the percentage, 97% of the covered with the marine water, okay. In that marine water, salt is more content is present. So India marine fisheries source includes 7500 kilometers of the coastal line, and the deep sea is behind it. Popular marine fishes varieties, mackerel, tuna, sardine, and Mumbai duck. So these are the marine fisheries name. What is the marine fishes name? Okay, how much kilometers are present? 7500 kilometers of the coastal line is present in India. In India, what are the popular marine fishes varieties? Mackerel, tuna, sardine, and Mumbai duck. So these are the examples of that marine fisheries. Breeding, mating, and then producing the young ones. So if they are participate in the reproduction, they are giving to the new young one. So that is called breeding. The common and dangerous disease in the cows and buffaloes: nattala vyadhi, galikuntu, viral infection, bacterial disease. What is that? Can you say the answer? Avinash?
Yes, sir.
What is the common dangerous disease in the cows and buffaloes? Nattala vyadhi, galikuntu, viral infection, bacterial infection. Galikuntu. So second one is the correct answer. What is that? Galikuntu. Is it okay? Who discovered the pasteurization method?
Johnny Pasteur.
Pasteurization method discovered by whom?
Johnny
Louis Pasteur. Preservation of the milk is called pasteurization. Preservation of that milk is called pasteurization. In pasteurization, milk is heated at the temperature of how many degrees centigrade? 62, 72, 82, 92. What is the answer?
72 degrees centigrade.
Next. So the doctor who provide the treatment and the health care of the cattle is called neurologist means nerves, dentist means teeth, veterinary doctor means especially study of that cows and buffaloes animals. None of the above. What is the answer? Veterinary doctor. Next, layers are the reared for the production of meat or eggs. Layers are reared for the production of layers eggs, no? Broilers meat, no? How many remaining? Okay. So last lesson, what is the last lesson? So production of the food from that plants. Okay, last lesson is the why do we fall ill? Okay, why do we fall ill? This is the last chapter. We will discuss next class. Okay, once we have that exam is there. Once throughout that biology, physics, chemistry and mathematics, overall 100 marks. Mathematics is the 40 marks and physics is the 20, biology is the 20 and chemistry is the 20. According to the textbook questions only we will give, and prepare well for the exam.